Today's video is about carabiners. So we're just gonna go ahead and start by talking about the strength rating of carabiners. Written along the spine of any carabiner is gonna be the ratings for that carabiner. These ratings are gonna start with the letters KN, which represent kilonewtons, and then an arrow dictating the direction of force, and then a number. So this says KN, an arrow indicating pull in the vertical axis, and then you can see it says 23. So this means that this carabiner can take 23 kilonewtons of force in the vertical axis. Then this carabiner has a picture with the gate open, depicts it like this, and it says 8. So it can take 8 kilonewtons of force with the gate open. And then it shows it across the gate, so in the horizontal direction. And it says 10, so it can take 10 kilonewtons of force in this way. So you can see your carabiner is most strong in when it's oriented in the vertical axis. So we always want to try to keep our carabiners oriented in that direction. A kilonewton of force is roughly equal to 225 pounds, so 23 kilonewtons is a lot of weight or a lot of force that one of these carabiners can hold. So let's talk about the parts of a carabiner. You have the spine of the carabiner, which is the back side. You have the gate, which is the part that opens. And then you have the little tooth, or key lock, we're gonna get to that in a second, that the gate actually closes onto and makes a round connection there. So you'll see on this carabiner, it kind of has like a tooth there, and this is the older style. This tooth can get caught on ropes and stuff. And to look at a new style, you'll see that that tooth is now gone, and this is called a key lock. So this is smooth here, doesn't get caught on stuff when you clip to it. So let's just go ahead and start by talking about the non-locking carabiners. So the first one on the left here is just a standard non-locking oval. And this is the type of carabiner that was used in the old day climbing. It's still really good in the modern day for certain applications. These are used commonly in aid climbing, or maybe three of these are used in tandem to make a master point for a top rope anchor. Moving along, we have pretty much the same carabiner, except this one is in a D shape. So what the D shape allows is for the rope or whatever you have clipped to it to sit really close to the spine of the carabiner, which is the backside here. And this allows a lot of the weight to be transferred to the spine rather than in the center here. The weight is kind of distributed between the gate side and the spine side. So the difference between having an oval compared to the D is that the D is a stronger shape because, like we said, the weight is distributed along the spine of the carabiner rather than between the gate side and the spine side. So whereas this oval is only rated to 18 kN across its vertical axis, this one is rated to 27, the D carabiner. So moving into our newer style non-lockers, you got a bent gate, which allows for easy clipping of the rope. This type of carabiner is primarily going to be used on quick draws and maybe on people's cams. Then you got your straight wire gate. This is a pretty new Black Diamond Neutrino carabiner. It's pretty lightweight, and you can see that the gate is actually just a little thin wire gate here. Contrary to beginner's belief, these carabiners are just as strong as ones with straight gates. So this straight gate carabiner next to it is rated to 23 kilonewtons vertically, and this little new age wire gate is actually rated to 24 kilonewtons vertically. So you can see how these carabiners are still really strong. And then we just have a bigger, a little older, heavier version of the Black Diamond Neutrino here, straight wire gate. And then we have a wire gate carabiner that is also a bent gate. So you can see how the gate is kind of bent in the curve shape here. This is a lightweight carabiner that is also easy to clip with a rope. So these would also be used primarily on quick draws. Moving into the locking carabiners, we have a couple different locking mechanisms. We have a screw gate locking mechanism, which you screw up or down. So down, unlock, up, lock. And you got your auto locker, which automatically locks. You can see this one's locked, and you twist, open it, and then it automatically locks for you. So there's a couple different types of locking carabiners. You can see I have these big wide ones, which kind of look like a pear if you turn it like this. So these have a couple names. You can call them pear shape. You can call them HMS. You can call them Munter carabiners, or some people call them belay carabiners. So these carabiners have a really wide top to them and kind of a narrow base. And this allows for you to put a bunch of rope in here and work a Munter hitch, or allow your belay device to move back and forth easily while keeping it centered and straight on your harness on the small side here. So pear-shaped carabiners. This is a screw gate, auto locking. This is a D-shaped carabiner, a locking D-shape. So it's just like this one, except shaped in a D. I like to use these locking D-shape for building anchors and things like that. They're really cheap, economical carabiner. Then you kind of got your standard, little nicer than the standard D-shape. This is also a kind of hybrid D-shape, and it's just a general use carabiner, also a screw gate. Then you got your D-shape carabiner that is actually hollowed out in areas, milled out, to be extra light. And this is a nice screw gate locking carabiner that's really light and also really strong. It's 28 kN, so just as strong as some of the thicker, heavier carabiners. And this is a great carabiner to take up on big walls when you need a locking carabiner and you got to carry a lot of weight. So there's always new carabiners coming out on the market. Black Diamond now has two new ones, a magnetic locking carabiner and a carabiner they call the gridlock, which has a mechanism to keep it oriented in the correct direction all the time. So it's good to check out what's on the market. I always just choose carabiners that are best gonna fit my need. So if I need a big belay carabiner, I go with one of these HMS. If I need some good anchoring carabiners, this D-ring, quick draw carabiners, or carabiners for my cams, any of these non-lockers here. And maybe for my aid climbing, I might go with these cheapo old school ovals, or maybe this D will work great. For climbing big walls, when you need to save weight, I would go for one of the lighter locking carabiners, or also the lighter non-locking carabiners.